Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Greetings, saints, in the wonderful name of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Over radio and those watching over Facebook, greetings in Jesus' name. Pastor Ntuli, with your spouse, all the members of the pastorate, members of both boards, elders and deacons, with your spouses, all the leaders of the church, members of MIAC, by Tibarona, greetings in the name of Jesus. Reminding ourselves about this God that we serve. Because when you live in life, it's easy that you be overwhelmed by situations. But it is critical if you know the God that you serve. There is always a name of God that will fit perfectly in your situation. And you are therefore strengthened to move on. We spoke about the God who heals. And we spoke about God who is there, right where you are. This morning, we want to talk about the God who provides. The God who will see. He foresees your need before you know you will have a need. And because he foresees that you will have a need, when you come to your point of need, he's the Lord who will see to it. We're in Genesis chapter 22, verse 1. To verse 14. I want to believe if I had pages and pens and I would give every one of us and say, just write your need. I want to believe no one's paper will come back blank. This morning, we will experience this God. Every single need that you have,
we'll
experience this God, who is so faithful, so trustworthy, who never fails to keep his promise.
Hallelujah. Ngizofunda encwadini kaGenesis chapter 22 evesini lika 1 until ku 14 ngesiZulu ifundeka kanje kwathi emva kwalezo zinto uNkulunkulu wamvivinya uAbrahama wathi kuye Abrahama yena wathi ngilapha wayesethi Tata manje indodana yakho eyoda oyithandayo uIsaka uye ezweni laseMoriya unikele khona ngaye abe ngumnikelo wokushiswa entabeni ethile engiza kukutshela yona uAbraham wavuka ekseni wabophela imbongolo yakhe wathatha ezimbili ezincekwini zakhe no Isaka indodana yakhe waqanda izinkuni zomnikelo obuza kushiswa wasuka waya endaweni uNkulunkulu abemtshele yona ngosuku lwesithathu uAbrahama waphakamisa amehlo akhe wayibona indawo isekude uAbrahama wathi ezincekini zakhe hlalani lapha nembongolo Mina nomfana siyalaphaya sikhuleke sibuye size kini U-Abraham watata izinkuni zomnikelo obuza kushiswa. Wazibeka phezuka Isaka indodana yakhe. Waphatha esandleni sakhe umlilo nomese. Bahamba bobabuyili kanye kanye. U-Isaka wathi ku-Abraham uyise. Baba, wathi yena, ngilapha ndodana yami. Wayesethi, bheka, nanku umlilo nezinkuni, kepha iphi imvu yomnikelo ezoyishiswa na? U-Abraham wathi, uNkulunkulu uza kubonelela imvu yomnikelo ezokushiswa ndodana yami. Bahamba bobabili kanye kanye. Bafika endaweni uNkulunkulu amtshele yona. U-Abraham wakha khona i-altar, walungisa izinkuni, wambopha u-Isaka indodana yakhe, wambeka i-altar phezu kwezinkuni. U-Abraham waselula isandla sakhe, wathatha umese ukuba ahlabe indodana yakhe. Kwase kumemeza kuye ingelosi kaJehova esezulwini, ithi, Abrahama, Abrahama. Yena wathi, ngilapha. Yayisithi, ungabeki isandla sakho kumfana, ungenzi lutho kuye, ngokuba ngiyazi manje ukuthi uyamesaba uNkulunkulu. Lokhu ungagodlanga kimi nandodana eyodwa yakho. U-Abrahama waphakamisa amehlo akhe, wabona, wabheka ngemuva inqama. Ibhajiwe esihlahleni ngezimpondo zayo. U-Abrahama waya, wayithatha inqama, wanikela ngayo umnikelo wokushisa esikhundleni sendodana yakhe. Verse 14. U-Abrahama waqamba igama laleyo ndawo ngokuthi uJehova uyabonelela. Njengalokhu kuthiwa namuhla entabeni kaJehova kuyabonelelwa.
Kamorago ga lebaka mudimo a leka Abrahama a mmitsa are Abrahama yena a araba are ke nna yo mudimo are tsia morwa gago yo ile go yena a noshi Isaka yo morata go kudu o yena geng ya Moriah fa o ntirele sehlabelo sa go tshungwa ka moka ka yena thabeng ye ke tla go laitsa yona ka le latela go e sale bosego Abrahama phapha dikgong tsa sehlabelo a saletsa pokolo ya gagwe gomme a tloga le Isaka le bahlanka ba babedi ba le ba felo fa o modimo a mmoditsego gona ka letšatši la boraro Abrahama a bona felo fao a sale kgojana ke mo a itšego go bahlanka šalang mo le pokolo ye nna le mošimanyana re tla fetela mola go yo rapela mme ka morago ra boela mo go lena. Abrahama a rwesa Isaka dikgong tsa sehlabelo gomme yena a swara thipa le magala a go gotsa mollo ge bobedi bja bona ba swere tsela mmogo. Isaka a re go tatagwe tate tatagwe a araba a re eye ngwana. Isaka a mmusha a re mollo le dikgongshidi kwanyana ya sehlabelo yona e kae. Abrahama mo fetola a re modimo o tla inyakela yona ngwanaka gomme bobedi bja bona ba fela ba swere tsela mmogo ge ba fihla felo fao modimo a mmoditsego gona Abrahama a aga altare gomme a beakanya dikgong godimo ga yona a tlema morwa wa gagwe gomme a mmea altareng godimo ga dikgong ka ke moka a tšea thipa gore a mmolae eupia morongwa wa morena a mmitsa a le legodimong a re Abrahama Abrahama yena a araba a re ke nna yo morongwa a re o se gobatse mošimanyana yo goba wa mo dira selo bjale ke a tseba gore o boifa modimo ka ubane ga se wa gana go moneela wa se wa gana go moneela morwa wa gago a nnoshi Abrahama ge a lebelela a bona kgapa e tantswe ka sethokgwaneng ka dinaka aya a itšea mme a dira setlhabelo sa go tshungwa ka moka ka yona legatong la morwa wa gagwe 14 Abrahama a rea felo fao leina la morena o a fa gomme le lehono batho ba sa re thabeng ya morena o a fa.
Will you please pray?
Oh, I love him. Oh, I love him. Oh,
amen.
Let's give you a brief background. Just to remember that Abraham had this son Isaac in his very, very old age. After God spoke the promise that have a son. He waited about 25 years. In the interim, he and Sarah devised a plan and they had Ishmael. Now at this time, in chapter 21, God tells Abraham to let Ishmael and Hagar leave the house. So, Abraham is left with Isaac. The promise that God has given him. Now when God says to Abraham, take your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering. You see, a burnt offering is a different kind of offering. Of the offerings in the Bible, a burnt offering is that offering where everything fat and all is laid on the altar for the Lord. Abraham faced life's most difficult test. God doesn't say, take Eliezer. Remember, at some point before he had a son, he thought Eliezer, his servant, would be his heir. God doesn't say, take Eliezer, because Eliezer is a symbol of Abraham's wealth. He doesn't speak when Ishmael is there. He doesn't say, take Ishmael. Because Ishmael is a symbol of Abraham and Sarah's own creation.
Okay, all right. Ooh, come again, Mfundisi, uthini.
He doesn't say, take
Ishmael
and sacrifice him. Because
Ishmael
was a decision between Abraham and Sarah. It wasn't Isaac that God spoke about. He doesn't say, take Lord and sacrifice him. Because Lord is a symbol of compromise. When God told Abraham to move out of Ur of the Chaldeans, he didn't say, take your nephew with
him.
He says, take your son, your only son,
Isaac.
Let's go back. When God promised Abraham Isaac, he said, I will make you a father of many nations. Abraham knew that a son would come out of his loins. And this was the son that was given by God. And God says, take that very son. Now we are to see, is
Abraham
thinking that the promise to make him father of many nations, is it still with God or is it with
Isaac?
You see, there will be times when God makes a promise and he provides. We tend to forget the source and hold on to what we have. But Abraham shows his faith. When they walk to Moriah, the Bible dictionary says, it's a walk of 3 days and 3 nights. They are walking to Moriah. We learn something from Abraham. He doesn't take shortcuts. He listened to what God has said. And he does what God has said. And that's very critical. I said on the mountain of the Lord, it shall be provided. Because he's Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides. Sometimes as believers, we ask the Lord, he provides, but we miss to receive it. There were many mountains, but the specific mountain was Moriah. It wasn't the nearest mountain, but it was where God, remember I said he's God who foresees your need. The ram in the thicket was nowhere else but on Mount Moriah. So although he's God who provides, Abraham had to move in faith. Abraham had to obey God to be able to receive from God what he needs.
Come on, come on, come on. Preach it.
He must go
Foot eye
to the right place.
Enter when le lungele
at the right time.
Yes, kasi le sigahle.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When Isaac asked him, he sees they've got the wood, they've got everything. But you are leaving the critical thing, the lamb.
Abraham.
You can see he's a man of faith.
We are born of
God, revive our faith. Abraham says,
Abraham,
God himself will provide the lamb for the burnt offering. God did not tell him about the ram. God told him about Isaac. But the faith of Abraham, he knows that where Isaac comes is the source of what we need. And he prepares everything. He lays the wood. He is ready to do it. The Bible doesn't say what Isaac said.
All right.
Hey, yeah. Isaac. You know, especially when it comes to where, after tying him, putting the wood, and taking the knife,
no mess.
But Isaac had to experience the God of his father Abraham.
All right.
And he says, do not lay hand on the boy. Do not do anything to him. You see, by this time, we can all agree that Abraham did not demonstrate common faith. But he demonstrated faith that honors God. You see, the faith that honors God gives back to God what God has given to us by grace. And that faith will show whether we love God more than we love the promise that was given. Sometimes when we say the Lord should provide, we tend to love the provision of the Lord more than we love the God who provides. Faith that honors God acts on the word of God. You see, if we need to have faith that honors God, we need to move in the word of God. Abraham moves in the way God has spoken. He's a man of real faith. It's not a faith that believes in spite of the evidence. But it's faith that obeys in spite of the perceived consequence.
Mm.
Listen to what God says. He says, now I know that you fear God because you've not withheld from me your son, your only son. You see, you will look at the sacrifice, but God did not want Isaac as the sacrifice. God wanted Abraham's heart. Zalwani, can God have your heart? This heart that will let God be God. This heart that will honor God every time, irrespective of the consequences. This heart that will say, whatever you say, God, I agree. It's not the sacrifice. It's the heart. And the God that we serve, the God who provides, does not look on the outside action of putting Isaac on the wood. He's looking on the inner truth of your heart. How is your heart when you have needs?
How are you so? Come on.
How is your heart before God? When you have a need, you see sometimes. We fail to receive what the provider provides. God had Abraham's heart. Abraham looks up. And there in a thicket, he saw a ram caught by its horns. The Lord gave a substitute. Instead of Isaac, there was the ram. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, this sacrifice, Genesis 22, verse 13, is actually a type of Jesus Christ. The sacrifice for all of us. Let's talk briefly about the providence of God, because when we talk about Jireh, provision, the Lord will see. God provides the needs of men every time. Not the want. The needs. The word providence means to see before, and therefore by implication, to do something about the situation. Do you have needs, Bazalwan? Do you have needs, Bazalwan? What about us today? Matthew 6:25 says, do not worry about your life. What you will eat or drink. Or about your body. What you will wear. Nekumbula leyo verse. It means in other words, if I believe in this God who provides, I will open my cupboard, open my fridge, and it looks like there's no food. But I will set the table, knowing that at 6:30, it is time for dinner. And God knows that my children are hungry. He knows that I am hungry. And at 6:30, we will eat. Sometimes we want to have the food, but we don't lay the table. Abraham took the wood. He took the fire. He took Isaac. He tied Isaac. He put the wood on him. He took the knife.
Come on.
Hallelujah. You know, I was I was reading another article of this Christian woman, and she was talking about the God who provides. And she was saying she didn't have any food at all. And she kept on telling people that her God will never fail her. And she says she had an impression in her heart that they are going to eat. And then she sets up the table. And as she's doing so, the child comes running and saying, there are people in a car, they're asking if you are there. And she goes and she doesn't know these people. They come in with food that is cooked and they say, the Lord said, we must bring this. And they leave. She never saw them again. As if that was not enough. She said, after 2 days, somebody went. You go and pay there, and then they send a child to say, come and take. She gets such a message. God still provides. God still provides. She provides our basic needs. She provides what we need. Abraham called it that place where he encountered the provision of God. The Lord will provide. After his faith was tested, he is now strengthened. Hallelujah. God's provision is perfect because he knows what we need. He knows where we need it. And he knows when we need it. He's the Lord who provides. He provides the need of all creation. Let's take it slow. Mfundisi Ntuli.
Mruti Ntuli.
Angithi wena you are a farmer.
Akere wena umulimi.
Ulima ngezinto zaphansi.
Ulima ka dilo xa fast.
My Bible teaches me.
Bibele yaka ya nthuta.
The Lord
Morena
provides for the earth. Besides umobu
it
is God who will give rain to the soil so that you have crops, so that there's food security. Lentswe la Modimo le re, he covers the sky with clouds. He supplies the earth with rain and makes grass grow on the hills. Kuri, he provides for the earth wahula spinach and cabbage, but the grass for the cow and the sheep to eat. He provides for the animals. Psalm 145 verse 16. You open your hand and satisfy the desires of every living thing. Every living thing. Linonyane haina limatsuatsuane. God provides for it to provide. And when he provides, he doesn't choose. He provides for all people. He provides for a sinner. He provides for a saint. He provides for a murderer. He provides for a robber. He provides for everybody. He provides even for those who don't recognize him. Hey, come with me to Acts chapter 14. In Acts chapter 14, Paul
Paul.
14.
14.
Paul and Barnabas.
Paul and Barnabas.
They are in Lystra.
Lystra.
They come to this place and they see a man crippled. And God heals the man. And those people call them Zias. They think he's a god. And they come, they bring the bulls. They want to sacrifice for them. And then Paul preaches to them. Listen to what he says. He says, we are not God. But he says, God has shown kindness by giving you rain from heaven and crops in their season. He provides you with plenty of food and fills your heart with joy. God, that you don't even know. He provides for every person.
I'd offer mang leka pa mang.
He provides also specially for the poor and the needy. Psalm 146.
146.
7 to 9 says.
7 to 9.
He gives food to the hungry.
Offer di jo uba
waswaro
naiva inza baseli mpopangis.
Food to the.
Good la gula bapi la balambile.
And he sets the prisoners free.
He
gives sight to the blind. He lifts those
labo
who are bent down.
Labo laba kobegile.
Let's talk about special instances in the Bible. Just to charge our faith one more time. Maybe you had that need for so long. You've come to a point where you think, maybe God will not provide this one. Do you remember in the wilderness? Do you remember in the wilderness when Israel was hungry? God provided manna. God provided quail. Still in the wilderness, when they came to Mara and the water was bitter, God made it sweet. He provided sweetness in bitter water. We are talking about the God who provides. Your placement doesn't change what God can do. He provides in your house. He provides in the wilderness. He's the Lord who provides.
My Jesus.
Let's think about one of his prophets. The prophet Elijah. When you come to 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 6. In 1 Kings chapter 17, when the chapter
17,
starts,
verse 6,
the prophet Elijah goes to the king and says, there won't be rain until at my
weight.
So it's famine. There is no food. Elijah stays by the brook. And 1 Kings 17, verse 6, look at the God who provides. He chooses ravens. Not doves. Not eagles. He chooses ravens. That you will think are dead.
No.
You see, when you need, when you have a need, and you have asked God to provide, don't look at the person. You don't look for a man Shaba, with a suit, a tie, and a case. God will use a man with an overall, with tontekis, to provide for your need because he is God. Do not look at man because man doesn't provide. Look unto God because it's God who provides. He gave Elijah
a
bread. When everybody didn't have food, a raven brought him bread every day.
Come on, come on.
And he drank water from the brook. And the Bible says, then the brook ran dry. You see, the same God who provides, he spoke water into existence. He could have kept the brook to have water. But God wanted to provide for a widow and a son. Am I talking to somebody? Am I talking to somebody? When the brook runs dry, Elijah doesn't try to dig for water. He listens to God. And what God says doesn't make sense. He says, go to Zarephath. He doesn't say, go to the Jews. He sends him to Zarephath. He says, there's a widow. It doesn't make sense. A widow must be taken care of. As if that's not enough. When Elijah gets to the place, the widow says, just a little flour and a little oil so that me and my son can eat and die. I'm talking about the Lord who provides. When you come to 1 Kings chapter 19, Prophet Elijah, Prophet Elijah, after God deals with the 400 prophets of Baal, and Jezebel speaks, that boat filled with faith prophet is now scared. He runs away. He desires to die. And then he sleeps. As he sleeps, an angel of the Lord wake up and eat. In 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 5 to 8. You know, Bazalwane, I'm giving you these verses so that when you go and read it, your faith will be lifted. The Bible says, then he lay under a tree and fell asleep all at once. An angel touched him and said, get up and eat. He looked around, and thereby his head was a cake of bread baked over hot coals. And a jar of water. He ate. He lay down. He slept again. The angel came again. He eats again. He sleeps. The angel comes again. And he says, eat. The road you are going to take is very long. And he continues to eat. And I love what the Bible says. Hey, go and read it, Mzalwa. It says for 40 days and 40 nights, the eating that God provided sustained him. Yeah, God makes a special provision for us as his children. Remember what Philippians 4 verse 19 says. It says, my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. He said, when we think of a God who provides, he also provides protection. Psalm 91 verse 4. Do you seek protection? Psalm 91 verse 4 says, he will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you'll find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and your rampart. Hey, let's talk about a shield and a rampart. You see, a shield means it stands between me and my enemy. The enemy cannot access you because you are shielded. But when he talks about the rampart, you remember when we look at the movies, usually it's Bible times movies where they are fighting. Soldiers that side, soldiers this side. And you see they put sandbags. And then they lie flat this side. So when the enemy tries to shoot them, because of the scent, they shoot the scent and their ammunition, the bullet can't go through. That scent bag is a rampart. He is our shield and our rampart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He provides for their every need. Times against us, my Jaws. You see, sometimes you just need peace. You need inner peace. You've tried your best. You struggle to have peace. Philippians 4 verse 7 says, the peace of God that transcends all understanding will guard your heart and mind in Christ Jesus. If it's of God, who provides it? It can't be our mind. It cannot be a psychologist. It can't be a psychiatrist. It cannot be a social worker. It has to be God. He provides peace. Hey, Bazalwani, if you need peace, remember the Bible says you must guard your heart with all diligence. So immediately you are robbed of peace. You must seek the peace of God so that your heart remains guarded. Because out of the heart flows the issues of life. We need the peace of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you struggle with demonic oppression and resistance and attacks? Colossians 2 verse 10. Skatatazela. It's not you, given by grace. It says you have been given the fullness of Christ. Who is head over every power and authority. It's there. You have been given, received. God provided it through Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He provides security. Sometimes, last week he was talking about promoting some people. Then he'll put you in this place. And everybody will tell you it's not safe. People in this position don't last. 2 Samuel chapter 7 verse 10 tells me. God says, I will provide a place for my people, Israel, and will plant them so that they can have a home of their own and no longer be disturbed. Wicked people will not oppress them anymore as they did in the beginning. God will give you security. Sometimes you go through pain. You go through grief. You lost your loved one. You lost valuable things. Isaiah 61 verse 3,
Isaiah 61 verses 3
says, God provides for those who mourn in Zion to restore to them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, oil of gladness instead of mourning, a garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair. He's the Lord who provides. Sometimes you may feel like you've been captivated. Maybe you have backslidden. Maybe you are hooked to alcohol or drugs, whatever. You feel like you are in captivity. Jeremiah 33 verse 17 tells us God provides restoration out of captivity. It says Judah and Israel, he'll bring them back from captivity and will rebuild them like they were before. Now this provision of God, this God who provides, what does it mean to us? What does it imply? We are free from worry. We can be generous like Abraham was generous because we know the source. We can be faithful in whatever God desires of us because we have seen he can be trusted. He is God who provides the right thing at the right place at the right time. What sees your need even before your need arises and he makes provision for it. What is your need this morning? Can we all stand? What is your need this morning? Is it a short list? Is it a long list? Is it a whole book of needs? On the mountain of the Lord, it shall be provided. He provides all your needs. There is no need that you have that God cannot provide. Trust him. Obey him. God will provide the right thing at the right time, at the right place. Hallelujah.
Mighty Jesus.
Can you give us a song? This one is personal. If we say altar call, everyone will come because we all have needs. Your need may not be what I need, but God knows your need. God has provided for your need. God will provide for you. He foresaw it solely.
We won't call
you see to it.
Utabona.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know what's your need.
Maybe
you are a child. You are doing so well. Your parents don't have money. You are already worried. For even if you write the exam, maybe you won't get the results. I'm here to remind you, on the mountain of the Lord, it shall be provided. Maybe you are in debt. You received a letter from the bank. They want to repossess your house. You've done your best. You are unemployed. Family can't help anymore. Friends can't help anymore. Remember that home is your Isaac the Lord had provided. The Lord will provide. Don't panic. Just trust him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Maybe you've been married for many years. Nina Bantwana, God blesses you with children. But you are struggling to get a home. Hey, I say the Lord will provide. He knows your needs. Just listen to him. His ways don't make sense. Muruti Magagula, don't look for a man.
Let's go to the
wasuit.
Netai. Netai.
Hota kugola wa magwini.
Guta loko kololo tsengi se mafe. Ngulungulu.
Kaurinswa komudi.
Wakuba ibuya kusimakaze. Mighty Jesus.
Today as we will sing and take time. Present your needs to God. And after presenting him, listen to his voice. Obey his leading. He says he'll give you bread to eat and seed to sow. But whether I get a business in a way, given, I don't know about me, I don't know about you. But all I can tell you is that everything you need,
Jesus,
he's already provided.